Hello friends, welcome back. Before we get into today's video, important announcement. If you're watching this right now, chances are you're interested in getting better at video editing. So that means that you might be excited about what I'm gonna announce to you right now, which is I'm gonna be organizing a 1-day in-person workshop in which I'm gonna teach you everything that you need to know to become a better video editor. If you're interested in that, then down in the description, there's a link that you can click where you find out when it's gonna happen, where it's gonna happen, and how you can join if you want to. And with that, let's get into today's video. So, couple days ago, I've scrolled through my YouTube feed and what did I see? A new Sam Kolder upload. I watched like the first minute or so and completely got my mind blown. As probably you did too if you've seen the video already. If not, go and make sure to watch Sam's video before you watch this analysis. So let's jump over to the computer and look at Sam Kolder's drone clips, which seems like he used a couple of leftover or the best drone shots that he had and turned it into an absolute freaking awesome video. As always, let's get into it. So even here already, like the first cool shot and it starts so cool right away. The beat, I love the beat, it's so cool. And then here what you see. Whoa, just happened. And so the intro was like four different shots. But they are all so super cool, and then the transitions are absolutely crazy. So let's look at the intro again, how that starts. Even here now, so first of all, you see how narrow this is where he's flying through here. So first of all, means that he probably used a smaller drone, maybe a Mavic Air, and then that's simply a bit risky, flying so close next to the objects through the trees here. I wonder how many drones he crashed within his career. And then super cool how it's flying towards a tent and then he masked out. Do you see that? Here in the back, you see that the mountains don't align up with those, so that he masked out the opening of the tent. And shows us the next shot behind it. And here you see that must have been an FPV drone. By the way, it's tilting and shifting back and forth. It's not your standard drone that's flying straight, flying in circles. So it really has this jet pilot motion. And he's flying so risky by going so close. And this was probably the thing that stood out the most to me. Here's this transition. I just don't see where the transition happens. Where does the freaking transition happen? I've watched it 5 times. After each other, and I just don't see it happening. It could be that here there's a mask. Out of everything that I've seen so far, that would be my best guess, but it's so freaking smooth how he's doing the transition. And then again, it's like a FPV drone. Here is again a super risky shot to get so close, and the transition is so cool by going in the mist of the waterfall and then transitioning behind a cloud. I mean, what are we talking about? Really cool with this drone shot, with any shot, if you want to give it more depth and want to make it more interesting, it's super important to have foreground elements because it gives this kind of parallax effect where the foreground is moving at a different speed than the background. So see this here? That's how we as humans see dimensions, so that makes it so much more interesting to look at. This one super cool shot as well. And here, although he's jumping between different times of year, different locations, different colors, it's like it fits together very nicely. And simply, it's really stunning imagery that he's getting out of those drones. Here with this one, super moody with the long shadows. Again, super crazy FPV drone flight. God, so close. This one, again, another really cool shot. What gives this one a really cool atmosphere is that you see on the left here, it's the sun about to go down, so shot it during golden hour. Perfect choice on the time of day. And then here, the thing is you need to think about is he flying backwards with a drone, obviously because this clip is playing forwards. That means that he does not see where he's flying backwards, but still he's passing by so closely next to the bushes and the trees. And the perfect tilt up in the end to see the mountain. And that could have been achieved afterwards if you filmed in higher resolution and then tilted it up, because you see here is the black letter bars. That's a big advantage when you edit your videos with letter bars. Again, super close, crazy fast FPV flight. Also, and then the question is, in which direction did he film this? So you see this in this direction. and then it reveals a rock, it reveals another rock, and then it reveals the tree that it flew through. And then you need to think about, did he actually fly this one backwards? I bet he did not. So how he recorded it was most likely that he flew forwards like this, and then over the mountain, and then tilted the gimbal down. That was, it was actually possible to fly through the tree and to control the motion and then the gimbal. It's perfectly timed, but then letting it play backwards makes it look 10 times crazier. Because you don't expect this. And then here again, it's the same trick. So here's the backside of the tent is simply masked out. And then here you see that shot disappearing. It still keeps staying there. And he does the exact same thing here. There's an opening in the trees that he masked out. Do you see this? And you see still there's the mask. And now you don't even recognize anymore that there's this mask because it blurs in so much. But if you leave it playing in the other direction, pay attention here, and now you see it appearing. Pretty, pretty epic. Every time that I see something like this, it gets me so excited because with every single of his uploads, he's trying to put the level a little bit higher, pushing the game a little bit further. And that's actually the way that you stay relevant, because there's been many other people who have become super famous quickly on social media, but to stay relevant and to stay on top of the game, that's what makes it difficult. And that was he simply achieves by pushing it further every single time. Again, super crazy FPV flight. So freaking close. This one, of course, super cool shot from inside that villa. Here again with the transition of the clouds. Goes into the cloud, fades completely to white. Here you still see that there's the trees, and then they fade away, and suddenly it's in the other cloud. It's just when you edit something like this, it's really about knowing your footage and recognizing spots that match up very well and then cutting them together and transitioning them smoothly. And that's what he's doing perfectly here. So fade to white because of cloud, fade to white again, but now in the wintertime. This one rolling backwards. This shot is absolutely epic. It's so moody and the sun has already gone down. Here, pay attention to the sound effect in the background that really sells the atmosphere with the water, with the sea. So this makes me want to get an FPV drone, seriously. The thing is also, you need to consider, like, is this flight actually happening that quickly or is it fast forwarded? But here you see her walking in normal speed, so that means that the speed that you see from the drone here is actually the speed in which it was really flying. So that means it was flying pretty fast. Again, super cool transition. In here that it turns around, goes out, and the mask between those rocks. From the other side. It means that the entire time when you saw this clip, it must have already been masked out here. Coming into the new shot. Here with this one, do you realize that the focal length that he has here on the drone must be a very long one? It's a very narrow field of view with the statue covered here. But then again, the drone seems to be very far away, because when you look at the motion with the mountains in the background and here, you see that the drone is traveling a very far distance, but yet the statue is very close. So he's been using a drone that you can switch lenses on. It's most likely an Inspire, I would guess, where you can have a longer focal length on it. Same here in this shot. And that one is so crazy. Do you hear the thunder in the background? Speed ramping in between. That was cool. So here he speed ramps out of this clip over the car. And here you actually see it fading out. So here, this is the transition between this clip and this clip. And in the moment that you look at it, you don't even see it. But now afterwards that we've looked at it frame by frame, you should rather see it. Yep. The second one is a clip that is fast forwarded, slowly tilting up the gimbal and flying through the trees. By the way, remember the plug that I made in the beginning? If you wanna see me analyze stuff like this for an entire day and teach you how to become a better editor, link in the description to my workshop coming up. This is so cool, I love it. That was such a cool video. And even that one, think about it. Did you see the transition? Let's look at it backwards, how he actually must have filmed it in this direction. But then again, where was the transition here? Where is the transition? So he's flying over the rock, and then here is the mask. Here you actually see the mask. Here's a lot of motion blur. Flying through the hole, flying through the next hole, but he's actually then playing it in reverse. And that's what makes it crazy, when you see the drone flying backwards and suddenly then an object comes into the field of view. This one, he must have actually flown it backwards. Because just look at her movement, she is actually running forwards while he's flying backwards. Ah! Can we please place bets on how high the crashed drone counts of Sam Kolder is? If I would just be able to get one single drone shot the way that any of these ones are here, I would be super stoked. But then again, all of his drone shots are like this. Here again, this one must have been flown like this, but still, it's so freaking... No, can't even be. Look at the guy, he's walking backwards. Do you see that guy walking backwards? So I thought it would be filmed like this, but that doesn't explain how the guy would be walking backwards. So he was actually flying backwards like this. So absolutely mind-blowingly crazy, as always. Super exciting to see how Sam is pushing the game. I hope you enjoyed this breakdown. As I said before, I'm going to be hosting a workshop. It's most likely going to be happening in 4 weeks from now. Down in the description, I want you to click the link. Go and check that out. If that's something for you, I would be really excited to see you and help you get better at video editing. And with that, there's a playlist with lots more of these reaction videos. Until next time.